Welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Heroes, Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. My voice is a little messed up. I don't know, coming down with a sore throat or something? I'm not sure. Anyway, we're coming from Nelva to... We can walk back here? Oh, we end up over here. That was weird. I didn't intend for that to actually happen. Yeah, we fully explored Nelva last episode. Now heading the Jade Road. We're heading for the next shrine in our pilgrimage here. Before we read this sign, we're gonna fight this. Poison Squirrel and Biter Wolf. Okay, oh, cool. Well, the wolves we've seen. Squirrels are new. Check it out. I'm not sure which food that was. We can't access our food from here, so just curious about that. Well, we're all full, so let's have Yurio do a finishing... I actually don't want to do a finishing move. They're all damaged already. Let's wait for a fresh battle, actually. I will, however... We have so many of those. Again, I'm going back to items. We have so many mind potions. We have, like, as much as we can possibly carry. So, might as well use some magic on these things. Do the Earth Spirit. And we'll do a cheer. This will do cheer to increase our defense. Not sure how much we'll need it. And he doesn't know magic, but he does have skills. Whirlwind. Hang in there! Here we go with the Earth Spirit. And my voice is really scratchy right now. Awesome. And Alf levels up. Alf is level 7 now, the same as the rest of us. Hooray! Alright, let's check out this sign now before we were so rudely interrupted. Nelva, the capital of Menarth, right? There we just are. And South Tyuyell, 2050 Milos. That's pretty far away. There's another 2050 Milos to Tyuyell, Yurio says. Chris says it's quite a distance. Well, they agree. Alf says it is far, but if you follow the road, we should not get lost since there's only one road to Tyuyell. Let us move on. Let us do so. But which way is the road? Alright. Finishing move on this poison squirrel. And then Chris will do her finishing move on the other poison squirrel. And then Alf will do his finishing move on this biter wolf. And then we'll have one left. What's he say? Something in my spear. I was missing. It's awesome. Bye-bye. Ow, 24 points. Oh, he's poisoned. Well, poison Yurio is going to make a meal out of you. Right, so next round, Chris is going to cure him of that. We also have a potion or two that we can use, but I would never use a potion when we can use our magic. Unless we need to use our magic for something more vital. So we're in Yurio attack, and then cure poison on Yurio. Yurio levels up. That's his reward for being poisoned, and Chris levels up too. Chris has learned avoidance up. What is that? Oh, we get vicious food. Vicious food. So what's the other way then? So there was only one road, but then there was a road heading east. So he's not poisoned now, so it only lasts the battle, I guess. These things are hitting pretty hard though, so I'm gonna just top Chris off a little here. So he gets banged up easily. So, oh, what'd you find? Cure potion! Oh, we're full of those. So there's also this way. And these enemies. They should, like, have a little more random chance for enemies. Oh, she's poisoned. Lengthy. I guess you call them animations. The rocks are animated. Okay, see, it goes away right as the battle ends. Got more vicious food. Okay, so now we'll use a mind potion on Yurio. Get most of those points back. Let me guess, the roads meet up together or something. Cheer, and then they'll just attack that one. One down. Cure that poison. We finally get to see the cure poison spell in a battle situation. She just yells cure poison. So I guess it must damage you a certain amount of points per round or something like that while the battle is in swing. Banging him around there. We got angel food. We're getting a lot of food from these, I notice. I'm gonna keep using this at the beginning of the battle, cheer. waiting for someone to get poisoned again. Was this the one we were banging on? I think? Or was it the other one? I'm not sure. It was probably that one, yeah. I'll use our finishing moves next combat. I have a feeling this episode's gonna be just fully getting to the next town. Yay, a mind potion. Sweet. I have an excuse to use Yurio's magic some more. We'll see what he says. Witness the might of my spear. That's what he says. Laser spear. Now, what did she get? It's a magic avoidance up. Okay. So I guess that's similar to the defense. Well, I think the defense, when you get hit, it's less points taken off you, but I think avoidance up helps you from being hit, so you see those misses. That's my guess. But, yeah, we don't need that right now. Ha! He says. So Yurio has a magic 34, okay. Okay, this goes to the next screen. So then where's this way go? I'll fight you, I guess. Now that we left that zone. The enemies come back. So the other way is where we came from then? Let's just take a look on the map, I guess. Bye-bye. I still don't know why it's called light cactus when it's ice. It just makes no sense to me. So Alf levels up. Sweet. Now he's ahead of us? Oh no, we all leveled up. That's right. Okay. I just kind of wanted to go around you. I wanted to look at the map. That's right. Let's do Water Spirit this time. Water. Gondor needs aid. I love the explosion sound. We've been lucky these things have not poisoned us lately. More vicious food. Alright, map. There's Nelva. So, I guess either way we end up over there? Because we can't go that way. We must go around. I'm just curious if there's anything over there, guys. Alright, so let's use a mind potion on... Here we go. And yeah, let's heal Alf. What the hell? And Chris. See if I can avoid this thing just once. Here we go. Whoop. I just want to see what's this way. Haha. No, this way is a dead end, Yurio says. Chris says, hey, what happened? I'm sorry, it's in my blood. My dad also has no sense of direction. You know, I must have come, like, right before this and head back. Here's a dead end. Alright. Sorry, guys, all this time just to find that out. It's an interesting exchange, though. Yeah, let's use some magic. I just wish they, it wasn't such a long, you know, pause waiting for the thing to, do its work. And then there were two. Another mind potion. I'm not gonna use it yet. Oh god. They're after us! Okay. Oh, there's so many. Oh my god. Oh, who's this? Wait. I was trying to avoid him too. Polka the traitor says, hello, are you going to Tyuyell? My name is Polka. I'm a trader. I'm going to Nelva to deliver goods to the toolsmen there. I heard that the sea monster Galga landed on Nelva and wreaked havoc. Are people in the town okay? Chris says, yeah, the buildings are completely destroyed, but everyone is in high spirits trying to rebuild their town. Okay, Nelva, a lot of the buildings are intact. I don't know about your memory, Chris. Polka says, "That was some disaster. I hope my goods will help them in some way. Hey, why don't you take a look at my stuff to see if there's anything useful? There are troublesome monsters around here." Yeah, you're not kidding. So tell me what you need. Alright, he's got potions. He's got a guard ring plus one. And a resist ring plus one. Okay, so this helps with magic defense. And that helps with, defense. So, we can use that to bring Yurio up 5 points. Chris up 5 points. Or Alpha up 5 points. 47. 200 platinum. Yeah, we can buy that. What does it say? Boost the wearer's protection and reduces damage from enemy attacks. And then a resist ring boosts the wearer's magical resistance and defends against hostile spells. I'll buy that too. Now we have 3 people who can benefit from this stuff, so... Thank you. I'll take a short rest before leaving. Take care along the way. Yeah, suit yourself. Okay. So he already has the power ring. Oh, before I do this, I just want to see if I can get an explanation of what this actually does. Helper spell helps a character dodge enemy attacks. Right, so it's more missing. Versus the cheer, which boosts defense. Yeah, I'm not completely clear on that, but I think it's... you don't take as much damage as you would. And the other just... you completely avoid attacks. I mean, you can. You have a better chance of it. So. Yeah, she's got this magic ring plus one. Will it say here what they do? Accessories? Okay. So I have to take it off her to get a description. That's a little, annoying. So the magic ring, we'll unequip that and then go into items, because I just want to take a look at this. Okay, the magic boosts the power of magic spells cast. Okay. And the resist ring helps resist against enemy spells, so... Alright, so... I'll definitely keep that for Chris. What does the white stone do? Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. I just want to see what this stuff... I forgot what the white stone does. I remember looking at it. Oh. Popular as a trinket. It does something, though. Oh, it boosts magic defense as well. Okay, so she already has magic defense. I wonder if that would I guess it does stack. Yeah. 38 even more. Alright, well, I'm gonna give her the magic ring. And as far as... Yurio's magic defense is 40. No, that's his regular defense, actually, sorry. Magic defense is 22. And Alpha's 20. Yes, okay. I'm gonna give the magic defense then to Yurio. Okay. And then I'll give the... the guard ring to Alf. Because he was getting down in hit points and surprised me a little. How's our pet doing? Good mood. Not hungry yet. Okay. Oh, wait. Yes. Okay. Continuing on our way. Now fighting these things. Here we are, finishing move. Oh, we got three of these poison squirrel things. Let's get our avoidance up. Let's do that. Oh, it only works for one person? Ah. See, I cast it on all three, but it'll take three rounds. Let's just do... let's just do the cheer, then. Which I think works... I guess the cheer... no, it works for everybody. See, at least two people are having it. Alright, well, he's full as well. So then let's use the other finishing move on this guy. Yeah, see, it doesn't affect Alf. I guess he's too far away from her. Because at least we'll get rid of two of these squirrels. Even out playing field a little bit. Maybe that's why he got also... Alf got so, damaged, because he wasn't including in our cheer defense thing. I mean, if I could, I'd put her in the middle, but I don't think there's a way to move your characters around. Like... change the order of them? Where they stand and stuff? Alright, well, I'm gonna do the Earth Spirit and have him take another potion afterwards. A huge explosion and everyone died. What? We get seafood and a power ring? Hell yeah. We ended up selling some of these rings soon because they just can only use so many. Actually, I probably saved some up for like a fourth party member. Well, we gotta see this. What's gonna be under accessories? Boost the wearer's strength, increasing combat effectiveness. I think Yurio's full of this stuff, but before we do that... yeah. Mind potion? And then out to equipment. So it's a power ring? So he already has a power ring. I'll give Alf the other power ring. The attack from 62 to 67. Sweet! It's the first time fighting something like that on a like an enemy. Look, I see the guy over there. East Nelva, 1065 Milos, and West Tyuyell, 985 Milos. So we're more than halfway there. That's awesome. Yeah, Yurio says, well, we're about halfway. Chris says, I don't like forests. I feel like getting lost any time. Well, other than that dead end, it's been pretty straightforward. Really? I love the smell of trees. Al says, Yurio, do you smell anything other than trees? Yeah, enemies. Yurio sniffs, I smell seawater. That is right. There's a sea just past this forest. Chris says, Yurio, you look like a dog. Don't tease me. Alright. Witness the wrath of Alf with his new power ring. I'm gonna do more magic. It's because these things are a little tough. Let's all pick on Chris time. This might just take out the wolves. And that one squirrel, maybe. The damaged one. I mean, if it wasn't for this magic and the finishing moves, these would be really challenging battles. But when you throw those in, it's a lot easier. And Yurio levels up, and Chris as well. They're both level 9. Another power ring. That's amazing. I don't think... Yeah, no one has space for it, so we're just gonna hold on to it. We'll find another party member. If we need it for money for something, then we'll sell it. Topaz Beach. Well, that's why we smell water, but we're in, like, cliffs area. Oh. Is that, like, a sailboat? Oh. Yurio says, hey, Chris, I think this is the boat we passed by right in front of Negara Island. I was careful to say that correctly. Chris says, well, it does look like that boat. That means the grandson of Grandpa Kevin Lodi is here. Alf says, ah, that young man who was searching for Galga? Yes. But there must be many boats similar to this. I don't think this one belongs to Lodi. What makes you say that? New song, though. Are there any creatures about? What's this one? Wait. Macho Battle Cry. Whoa! Huh? You hear yours says? What the hell? Oh, it's Lodi! Ouch! I think I hurt my back. Give me back my stuff! Hey, is it you, Lodi? Chris says. Yurio says, it's Lodi! It's you! But he has dollar signs for eyes. Now you can't get away. Codex is... Alf says, Lodi, do you need my help? I don't need anyone helping me. But how do you know my name? Oh. Ouch! Maybe I should... No, Lodi says. That's what happens if you try to steal from someone. You came after my stuff when I lowered my guard right after landing. What a cunning monster. Okay, you're talking to something that disappeared. Yurio says, you are so cool. That was magnificent, Alf says. Chris says, Lodi, you're so strong. Yuri says, it might, as might be expected of someone who is after Galga. Hey, hey, Lodi says, who are you? Why do you know so much about me? Sorry, we must introduce ourselves. I'm Chris. Nice to meet you. I'm Uriel. We're on pilgrimage. Do you remember we passed each other near the port of Negar Island? Chris says, I don't think he remembers. He looked very serious at that time. He couldn't have heard you calling him from the deck. Really? Uriel says. Of course. Galga finally appeared, but he lost his opportunity to fight with it. The village of Dakura was also destroyed. Think about his huge disappointment and shock. Okay, but you're talking about him now like he's not here. Yo-Yo says, you're right. Alf says, I also understand exactly how you feel. Well, my name is Alf. Stop. All of you, Lodi says. Don't just make assumptions about me. So how come you know so much about me? Yo-Yo says, we met Grandpa Kevin on Negar Island. Garrulous Grandpa. Well, that's a word. Alf says, I just met these three children in the village of Tatuta. Oh, these children. I'm like three. And have not personally met your grandfather, so, you know. Alright. Alf says, by the way, Lodi, what are you going to do next? You cannot be chasing up to Galga without any plan. My plan is to wait for Galga at Bolt in ambush. The monster will land on ambush. Why are you so sure? A witch left a prophecy which predicted Galga's attack on Tagura. When I was in ambush learning how to fight with a sword, I learned that the same prophecy was left there. The prophecy left in Tagura reads, when the earth forgets to produce, a mountain will cross the sea and you will hear the grief-stricken voices of people. The prophecy left in Nelva in ambush reads, an evil mountain will appear from the sea and leave the town in ruins. I'm positive. The coast of Bolt is the logical point to land on ambush. I will defeat Galga there. Chris says, but how are you going to overpower such a huge monster? Alf says, even if you are a swordsmaster, you cannot just rely on your swords. Is Lodi going to join our party? Then I'll give him the power ring plus one. Lodi says, I have an idea. I'm not committing suicide. Anyhow, I've talked too much. I must go now. I want to check something out in Tyuyell. We're also headed there. You can join us. Chris says, hey, you in the shorts, wait up. What? What's wrong with my shorts? Nothing. They look great. We're going to ambush, too. The more company we have, the easier our journey will be. Why don't we go together? Lodi says, I'm sorry, but you'll just slow me down. I'm used to traveling alone, and I like it that way. See ya. Aww. Well, here's Yuriyo to try to help convince him. Lodi, please travel with us. We're heading for the same direction, and I want to learn how to use a sword. No way. Don't be stubborn, Chris says. Travel with us. I said no. Well, we don't take no for an answer, do we? Alf says, I think these children like you. You should give up and join us. No pressure or anything. You two are talking nonsense. You're so persistent. Yes, we are, Chris says. I kind of like your shorts. Yuriel says, if we follow you all the way, it's the same as traveling together, isn't it? That's right, Chris says. I can't believe this. All right. I have no choice. I'll come with you. However, I'll leave you behind if you ever become a burden. Great, Yuriel says. So you're traveling with us? Yeah. Sweet. Lodi joins the party. Wow. Wasn't expecting that. Let's check out his stuff. So he's level 8 also. Needs to catch up to Yo-Yo and Chris, like Alf. 78 hit points, 30 magic points. So he does have some magic. He has a short sword and leather armor. He is not too well fitted. I'm going to give him the power ring plus one. Raise his attack from 53 to 58. Boop. We didn't have a chance to sell it, so that's good. And then as far as magic, the finishing moves, he has a sword fang. Oh, he has a sword fang as well, like Yurio's sword fang. And then as far as skills, he has aggressive, temporary increased attack power at the cost of defense. And then defensive, which is the opposite. Increase the defense at the cost of attack power. That's interesting. I guess that could be used tactically. Alright, that's that. Well. Anyway, now we have four members of our party. And a cure potion, which you cannot pick up. Anyway, I'm going to call an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.